Yo, what's going on, buddy? It's FunnFire here, back with another video, and today I'm going to be showing you guys the best hybrid blitz in Madden 20. Now, this is going to come to us out of the big dime 1-4-6 formation, probably my favorite formation in Madden 20, defensively, because of just how OP it is, the blitzes and the backup coverages behind the line of scrimmage. So much things you can do with the bluff blitzes, regular blitzes, you can send the whole kitchen sink at them and still have success running this play. So the play that I'm gonna be showing you guys, as you guys might have seen in the thumbnail, is gonna be this cover three sky. Now this is a hybrid blitz because we can either get pressure or we can just completely clamp up our opponents. It just really depends. Now coming out in it, I'm just gonna run it on the left side. I prefer running it on the left a little bit more than the right, but that's just personal preference. I always like running my blitzers on the left side, at least my corners. So I'm just going to come out in it, and right here, just come out in a regular offense play. I'm going to come out in this angle smash right here. Now, this blitz is pretty simple. Now, I'm just going to quickly respot the ball here, get a little bit more space for the blitz. So just move it back a couple of yards and get into our blitz here. So pretty much the only thing that you necessarily have to do in order to have success for the blitz, just to quarterback contain, and then what you do is just move this guy in. Now, something that you can do that would be a little bit better, save you some time, if you automatically come out in Herndon. So I'm just gonna hike the ball here and throw it real quick just to show you guys. So you guys see, I was using that slot corner on the left side for that play. Now the next play, you guys see I'm automatically on him. So for the setup, you're gonna have to quarterback contain and then move this guy in. If I was on Telvin Smith and I switched to that cornerback, then he would automatically move back and I would still have to move him in. In this case, I can just head back on Telvin Smith and he's automatically at the line of scrimmage, which is where we want him. So like I said, all you have to do is quarterback contain and then move that cornerback in so he's on the contain. And then what I like to do is just, all you have to do really is just user this linebacker on the left side and make sure that you engage with a block with the left guard. Is just a very simple thing, but if you don't do it, then you're going to be stuck and the blitz isn't going to work. We're only sending four people, so it's kind of necessary for the blitz. Now obviously we have a stock cover three behind us. You can obviously do whatever adjustments that you would like. You can do something like this, which is probably my go-to setup. It's just to put a on a vert hook and then put our linebacker on that right side in that purple zone. You can obviously put him in a cloud flat as well. So just some simple adjustments like that on the backside. The vert hooks, I have more success running. They stop seam routes, especially in the cover three, which is why I like these sort of slot corners in the zones. Now I'm just going to go ahead and hike the ball here and engage with that left guard. You guys see I engage with him and we get their pressure immediately. Unfortunately, Deshaun Watson is just breaking every sack. I think he might have an ability. So this was kind of a poor choice for me on the offensive side of the ball, but it doesn't matter that he's getting sacked in Ultimate Team. He's not going to break every sack. This is obviously a low overall corner. And something I forgot to mention is that you can just press him before the play. So I'll just come out here, press, quarterback contain, but it really doesn't make a difference that I'm on Telvin Smith. I can just easily move him in, move Telvin back in, and come out here. Now, I kind of prefer him moved out a little bit, like right here, but sometimes if you move him out too far and you get off, then he won't be in the contain. The blitz won't work as well. So like I said, just come out here, hike the ball. Oh my, I accidentally got glitched. It's hard to use two controllers for this, but you just have to make it work. But because I just hiked the ball and I accidentally clicked stripped, some things go wrong. So once again, press, quarterback contain, do whatever backside adjustments you want. Here, move Herndon in a couple of steps and we are perfectly ready for the blitz. Hike the ball here and get, I didn't even engage there, but we still got through. So that was a pretty nice animation. So that actually will happen sometimes with this blitz, which is the nice thing, is sometimes you can just run it. You guys see I go to engage, but he sort of goes to the left and we just get him coming off the edge free. It was pretty necessary for me to be in the gap there, but I didn't engage with anybody but the center, so it really didn't make too big of a difference. You guys see pressure gets there right away, and Deshaun Watson obviously breaks the sack, but that's not going to happen. in a game, you're not going to have a like 67 overall corner blitzing. You're definitely going to be able to find someone. So definitely put your fastest guy in the slot. He's just going to have the most success running it. That's just it. Show you guys one last time. This setup, I'll go into some other setups later in the video. So just underneath, under, over the top, and quarterback contain. You can press, do whatever, backside adjustments. Now I can also blitz A. It just gets me an extra blitzer, although it's not necessary for the four-man. Hike the ball, engage. It's just easier for me to engage if I blitz that other linebacker. There's not as much shifting going on, and it's just going to be cleaner, although you don't have an extra zone there, which obviously, if he's just snap-throwing like a streak to A, it could be a problem in this case, but definitely a little bit easier. He's only going to have a couple of seconds to throw, so you can do something like this. If you know he's going for the streak, just put RB in a curl and then run our same blitz. It easily could lock it up. Now, something that you can do as well is just put A in a vertical or A in a blitz, and then we pretty much have dual pressure. Quarterback contain, you guys see, unfortunately, this slot corner is in the QB contain somehow. I don't know how, but you do have to move him in a couple steps, and then obviously we don't have both guys hovered, but you can still come through obviously in a four-man or with the five-man blitz. You guys see, boom, both guys come off the edge screaming. So that's something great. You guys saw that the DN actually ended up taking our left guard assignment, so we ended up doing nothing pretty much again, but this is a great screamer off the edge, and we still have pretty close to a cover three. Obviously, the hover didn't even seem to be necessary there. Both guys just come screaming off the edge, and especially only blocking five, that's going to happen. Now, something that you can do, let's say he's blocking his running back in this case. What I'm going to do, press, quarterback contain, and then I'm just going to go ahead and blitz this A guy again. Now, this might not come through because as long as I actually do engage with this left guard, it should come through. Like the ball here, you guys see I engage, and we're easily able to come through screaming off the edge. So if you know he's going to block his running back, that's a simple adjustment you can make, and it still comes through in a very timely manner. So I'll show you guys that once again. Quarterback contain, manually blitz this A guy by clicking the D-pad to the right side twice for the quick adjust, and then clicking A in the right stick down. Move this corner in, and then just hover over again. Now, something that I actually like to do might be to just man everybody up. It's just a very simple adjustment. You guys see, we actually have A in a zone, so I can just do something like this. Put LB in that. This is a very effective zone. I can put LB in a curl flat and then cross man our safety on him. Even if he's in a streak that other guys should pick up and a slant, I can probably use her. I only have to engage for a couple of seconds, so I'm just going to block RB here, hike the ball, and you guys see I engage, and I can easily go back to usering. All you have to do is touch him pretty much for a second, enough to pick up. You should be able to know if you're going to get the pressure or not, so come out on that once again. But another thing that you can just come out and do, we obviously have our stock cover 3, but you can turn it into a cover 3 cloud, which is a setup that I love running. I actually have a video up on it if you guys want to check that out. So you can just do, let's say I turn this left side into a sort of a cover 2, then I can actually send A and then quarterback contain. If I can, move him in. If you don't, you know he's going to quick hike you, obviously you can just leave him on the blitz and it should be fine. But I can just come out here and then pretty much, even if he is max protecting, which I will, block 7 right here, I should still get pressure. Obviously, I'm sending 7 people as well, or not 7 because I'm actually using this guy, but I'm engaging, so it's like I'm sending 7. Just come out here, and we actually did get locked up there, surprisingly. Once you leave the engage and then someone gets bumped, they can easily just slide over, which is kind of unfortunate, but I'm actually not sure if I completely sent everybody there. So you guys see setup, just against a 7-man protection. It's going to be difficult to run. I have a different DB Sting 2 Buzz video that works against 7-man protection if you guys want to go check that out. So I'm just going to leave him on that blitz right there. Perfectly fine. And then just come out here, user, hover. You guys see this time, for some reason, our corner is just getting glitched. I'm not sure why he's not coming flying off the edge right there. So that's kind of annoying, but it's going to happen. This isn't the most clean blitz. This is more focused on coverage than it is our actual blitz. So for whatever reason, I have no clue why this guy is just cutting in. Maybe he has to be on the contain. So he's just going in the right guard for some reason, not coming off the edge. So that's the way that we need to get pressure. Try to get it right here one last time here before I end up concluding this video. So just gonna blitz all, press, quarterback contain, manually move this guy in, and then just move this guy in as well, put him on that blitz, get him on the, I'm not sure why, I guess I have to contain twice because he wasn't automatically on that contain, and then maybe make my adjustment of the cover two cloud on that right side, and just hover once again, max protect on offense, and engage with that left guard. You guys see, again, he didn't come through for some reason. I'm not sure what's happening, but you guys pretty much get the gist of the blitz. Just a very coverage-based blitz that can still come through. We're more focused on the coverage, so something like this is what a great adjustment that I can make. You can mix up the coverage in multiple different ways. You can run a bluff like this and still have success. I have the vert hook on that side. All I had to do was mix up that blitzer. I can do something like this, blitz the guy on the right, mix some things up, and all I have to do is use the flats myself. Still going to be a five-man protection, and you guys see just the vert hook's not going to cover the middle of the field. So different things you can do with this blitz and have success. Obviously, you should have your own personal preference on coverages on the backside, but those are just a couple of ones I like to run. The cover three stock obviously should lock up people enough, especially in a only five-man protection, that you should be able to get pressure. So if you guys did enjoy the video, please make sure to leave a like on it. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel as well. Show your support to the channel, and I will keep posting these videos for you guys. So also just leave a suggestion down below in the comment section on future videos you would like to see on my channel, and turn on those post notifications to be notified every single time I upload. And peace. I'm out of here.